Calling the meeting to order, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag.
The flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
Pam Dobus.
Here.
Barry Christensen.
Here.
Connie Rule.
Here.
Darren McGregor.
Here.
Jim Modrak.
Here.
Ken Nagel. Ken Nagel. Ken, are you there?
Here. Can you hear me?
Now I can. Yep. Kim Turner.
Here.
Russ Pacuzza.
Present.
Vince Scalzo.
Here.
9 members present.
Thank you. It is with great sadness that I share with you the unfortunate news that former school director Donna Cook passed away on Wednesday, April 22nd. Mrs. Cook served on the board from 2003 through 2019, with the last 10 years as board president. During her time as board president, she was admired for her organizational skills, and under her leadership, many things were accomplished, including the construction of the new high school at Bethel Park, the district-wide implementation of the one-to-one Chromebook initiative. She will long be remembered for her leadership and her commitment to the district. We extend our deepest sympathies to her husband, Tim, sons, Colin and Tyler, daughter-in-law, Brittany, and her beloved granddaughter, Alice. At this time, I would ask my colleagues and everyone watching this meeting to join me in a moment of silence to remember Donna Cook and her dedication to the Bethel Park School District. Thank you. At this time, I would like to have a motion to adopt the agenda for business items. Remember, when you make a motion, please state your name, and when you second it, also.
Jim Modrak, motion to approve business items.
Connie Rule, motion. Second.
It's been motioned by Mr. Modrak and seconded by Ms. Rule to adopt the agenda for business items. I'd like to remind everybody at this time that we have adopted a new kind of agenda for our business meeting. At our committee meeting last week, we went through every single item and we decided which items didn't require any more discussion and could be part of what we call a consent agenda, which can be approved en masse at the beginning of the meeting, with the other items then being the items that we might need to talk about. So that is a new way that we think we're going to be more efficient and less time consuming during our meetings. So now we have a motion and a second. Let's vote.
It's open.
Anyone?
Darren. Waiting for Darren.
Darren, you need to vote.
I'm okay with it. You guys just froze there for a minute.
Okay. So, yay.
Yes.
Motion passes 9-0.
The next item is the approval of our minutes for March 24th, 2020. I need a motion to approve.
Russ Pacusa, motion.
I second it, Darren McGregor.
It's been moved by Russ Pacusa and seconded by Darren McGregor to approve the minutes of our meeting on March 24th, 2020. Any questions or comments? If not, then please vote.
Aye.
Okay. Motion passes 9-0.
Okay, motion passes 9-0. I'd like to announce executive sessions, March 24th, 2020, April 2nd, 2020, April 9th, 2020, April 16th, 2020, April 21st, 2020, April 23rd, 2020, and April 28th, 2020 for personnel, other legal matters, and to receive information. Committee reports. Ms. Rule, you have some reports?
The AIU met yesterday by Zoom, and they have purchased 1,700 devices for school districts who really needed to have some devices to do some online learning from. They also are having classes for teachers who are not familiar with doing online learning, and they are now implementing classes for parents and guardians who also would like to learn the uses of online learning. That is for the AIU. Still that, Center.
Excuse me, Ms. Rule, can that be accessed through their site for parents?
No, they're gonna have it by Zoom also, but they have to notify the AIU and make an appointment.
Oh, okay.
Okay. For Steel Center, those students are continuing their classes. Our special needs students are being well attended to with phone calls as well as some online learning, and also that the NOCD people are agreeing to provide the NOCD tests for these students this summer. So that's a good thing. That's all.
Thank you. Any other committee reports? Okay, I'd like to remind everybody that you may make public comments at our meeting at this time and or after the meeting by emailing us at publiccomments@bphawks.org, and we will read those. At this time, the public comments are limited to those items that pertain to our agenda. And we do not have any at this time. Okay.
Yes,
we
Ms.
do
Cook,
have one.
There's
we
one
have
public
one.
Comment in regards to
okay.
Ms. Cook. If you, it's okay if I can read it.
Yes.
It's from John DeLallo from 1565 Lucille Drive, Bethel. Mr. DeLallo writes, I read with great deal of sadness of the passing of Donna Cook, taken from us far too soon. Mrs. Cook devoted many years to the service of the students of Bethel Park. I have no words to extend to her family and her friends that to possibly relieve their grief. But I have and will continue to pray for the repose of her soul. I would hope that all will recall her selfless service and join in a collective prayer. May the Lord bear her up on the eagle's wings to the bosom of Abraham. May she rest in the peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. That was from Mr. John DeLallo.
Thank you. If anyone during the course of the meeting would like to email us for the comments at the end of the meeting, we will also be reading comments at the end of the meeting. Again, publiccomments@bphawks.org for any comments. We'll now move into the business portion of our meeting. And our first item is the consent agenda. And on the consent agenda, we have 41 items. Are there any items on that agenda that any board member would like to hold out? Okay, I would like to move then items 1 through 41 on the consent agenda, and I need a second.
Second by Kim Turner.
Okay, Ms. Turner is seconding that. So we've got items 1 through 41 on the consent agenda, been motioned by Pam Dobus and seconded by Kim Turner. Any
hey, Pam,
discussion?
This is Aaron McGregor. I'm seeing 42.
Number 42 is our vote.
Okay. There we go.
Thank you. Any discussion on any of those items? Okay, so if you would then click on 42, that's where we will vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Another for the agenda? Okay. Motion passes 9-0. Okay, our next item is Mr. Scalzo, Curriculum Committee.
Okay, we have one item under Curriculum Committee, and that is high school elective courses. Would anyone like that to be held out?
So, are you making the motion for that particular item?
Making the motion to approve.
Okay, I need a second.
Second, Ken Nagel.
Okay, so it's been...
Second, Ken Nagel.
Thank you. Mr. Scalzo made the motion, and Mr. Nagel seconded it. And Dr. D'Imperio is going to do a brief summary of this particular, the electives.
Thank you, Mrs. Dobus. Each year, the high school offers additional courses from AP courses to theater courses, a wide variety to try to enrich our students' high school experience. One of the things that we're concerned about is, are the courses current? Are students still interested in taking these classes? So this initial list that is being approved touches upon the criteria of continuing to provide the youngsters in Bethel Park at the high school with high academic choices and also enrichment choices that are creative in nature. If the interest in some of these courses declines, we either eliminate the courses. This was not the complete list that was originally presented to the board, and we've already eliminated some classes in which the students showed little or no interest, and we have also, where there are very few students enrolled, have combined some classes to make it one class with more students in that class. So with that having been said, I think the electives have been well researched. They're ready to be approved by the board, and we do ask that the board approve them at this time so that the counselors and the administration at the high school can begin to prepare their course selection booklets so that the students know exactly what options are available to them. Thank you, Mrs. Dobus.
Thank you. And the numbers in the courses increase and decrease during the drop-add period for students also. So it's imperative that we approve all of these at this time, knowing that there still might be some movement after the drop-add period occurs. Any other questions or discussion about this? Okay, so then at this time, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Thank you. Mr. McGregor, Personnel Committee.
Yeah, we have two items on the agenda. One is reappointment of a contract, two-year contract for Jessica Koval. And the second one is a MOU with the Bethel Park Federation of Teachers. Would anybody like anything held out?
I think we have to vote these one at a time in the system.
Mr. McGregor, we have to do these individually anyway.
Okay, let's do number one first.
Okay.
So Cheska Koval, 56,721. Trying to toggle between one and two here. So go ahead.
So I need a second for that particular motion.
A second to Modric.
Ken Nagel.
Okay, it's been moved by Mr. McGregor and seconded by Mr. Modric that we approve this contract. Any discussion? Okay, open the voting, please.
Voting's open. Mr. Nagel? Motion passes 8-1.
Okay. The second one, Mr. McGregor?
Okay, we have the second item for personnel is the MOU with the Bethel Park Federation of Teachers dealing with the changes in working conditions with COVID virus.
I need a second.
I'll second Kim Turner.
Okay, it's been moved by Mr. McGregor and seconded by Ms. Turner to approve the Memorandum of Understanding with the Bethel Park Federation of Teachers.
Real quick, Ms. Dovis, it's been moved like with the COVID virus. However, we're talking about retirement dates and times to let's say that, you know, I do not want to retire, so we moved those dates back. So because of this COVID virus, we're extending that timeline for teachers to kind of just say, you know what, maybe I don't want to retire right now.
Any more questions? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Motion passes 9-0. Mr. Christensen, Finance Committee. Even though they are the similar items, we have to do them separately, Mr. Christensen.
Okay, very good. Then, under Finance Committee, I move to adopt number one, update of the crowdfunding approval list, policy 702.1.
I need a second.
Second, Jim Modric.
Okay, it's been moved by Mr. Christensen and seconded by Mr. Modric to approve the crowdfunding approval list. Any discussion on this item? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Motion passes 9-0.
Then for item number two, I move to adopt the approval of crowdfunding request.
Second, Russ Spicuzza.
It's been moved by Mr. Christensen and seconded by Mr. Spicuzza to approve the crowdfunding request. Any discussion? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Okay, Ms. Turner, policy. Oh, motion passes 9-0. Ms. Turner, policy committee.
I believe we have to take number one and number two. And are we voting just on number three, Mr. Carrazzi?
Final reading for number three, that's final reading, so we vote on that.
Okay. Number one is the waiver of the policy requirement for policy 213, and that is the assessment of student progress. That is the pass-fail grading system, but for 9 through 12 with the recommended changes to the high school grading system for the fourth quarter in the 2019-2020 school year.
I need a second.
Second, Connie Rule.
It's been moved by Ms. Turner and seconded by Ms. Rule to waiver the policy requirements for policy 213 because of the conditions of this that we're living under right now. Any questions about that? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Motion passes 9-0. Number two.
And the waiver of policy requirements in policy 217, the graduation requirements. The Board of School Directors approves the administration's recommendation of the suspension of identified provisions of board policy 217, graduation requirements as they apply to the class of 2020 seniors and the class of 2021 juniors to address the impact of COVID-19 during school closures. And this is the Keystone graduation requirement that the state is also recommending we suspend.
Second, Russ Spicuzza.
It's been motioned by Ms. Turner and seconded by Mr. Spicuzza to waiver the policy requirements for policy 217 regarding the graduation requirements. Any discussion? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Okay, and then approval of the final reading, the 006.2, the attendance at meetings via electronic communications. We did get the number for our policy number, so I recommend the approval of the electronic
communication. I need a second.
Second, Connie Rule.
It's been moved by Ms. Turner and seconded by Mrs. Rule to approve the policy 006.2, attendance at meetings via electronic communications, which will replace our current policy of the same number. Any discussion? Okay, let's vote.
Voting's open. Motion passes 9-0.
Motion passes 9-0.
And then finally, we have revision to policy 201, admission of students. This is the first of three readings, and the attachments and the red line were provided.
Okay, so at this point, we're not approving this because it's the first reading. So we didn't have this available for the committee meeting. So this is the first reading. So if anyone has any questions about this, you can ask them at this time. My only concern is, goodness gracious.
You're gonna make me gonna get there. I said you're gonna make me try and scroll on this, and I can't.
Is the first paragraph where it says title 22. This is, I'm assuming this is up on the website, Ms. Turner. Do you know? Is it under our policy revisions on the website?
Should be.
Or policies that we approved? Hello, is it?
Vicki Florida, yes it is.
Okay, great, thanks. So as I'm looking at it, it's the third paragraph. It's right across from where it says Title 22. I just am a little concerned about the subjectivity of that sentence. There isn't any criteria other than a written request, a recommendation, and an approval. I didn't know whether Amy, whether something could be in there regarding a proficiency on a readiness test or anything like that, or whether or not the recommendation of the district psychologist includes a readiness test of some kind. I was just concerned about, I don't have any problem with the approved schools or anything like that. I'm a little concerned about the subjectivity involved in that first
criteria. I believe when we edited this and looking at other boards, and Amy, please correct me.
Can you speak up?
There was additional options, but the options were for the parent or guardian writing a request letter to the superintendent, and then additional review by the district psychologist. I think we need to work on that last sentence a little bit more.
Yeah, is this PSBA language?
It's PSBA language and like about 14 different school districts from around the area.
Okay, so it's not uncommon then, it's not.
Right, okay. We can shore up that language, that sentence.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do, now that I read it for about the 19th time.
Because it just seems somewhat subjective rather than based on objective criteria.
Correct, so we can rewrite that.
So this
last
is the sentence. First reading, so we can look at that.
Yes.
Okay, anybody else have any other questions?
Well, Pam, I just agree with you. I mean, when you read that sentence, it's like, demonstrates readiness.
Yeah.
What is that?
Right,
mean?
So yeah. We need to put that. Right. I think we cut a little too much out of it.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I actually really like the rest of it, because we have had students who have attended kindergarten or first grade and other, and our policy didn't permit us to allow them in recently. So I really do like the rest of that, and I agree with that. It's just that first one I was a little.
And I think there were several edits that were passed around to the solicitor's office too. I think we may have edited a couple words out that probably need to go back in.
Okay.
So I'll work with Amy and get that all corrected.
Okay. Did you hear what we were saying, Ms. Zundel?
I did. Thank you both for that. I've taken a note of that. And then there was one other thing on this policy, the version of it that I believe is posted and that you all are looking at. There may be at the last section where it says kindergarten, I think there was a version that had that. There's a clerical error here.
Yes, I see it now. So let's fix that too, Amy.
Oh, I see it.
Let's get with Mary Beth on that.
Okay, thank you for that. Any other comments about that policy? Okay, we will now move to public comments that we have received. Mr. Spicuzza, you said there's another one. Would you read
two? There's two comments, actually.
Okay, would you read one?
Yes, absolutely. The first one is from Tracy Carnos, 5620 Tracy Drive. Excuse me. Can we have any information that has been decided to date regarding the senior students? Are there any plans yet for graduation in caps and gowns or yearbooks, all of which have been paid for? Will our kids be getting them anytime soon? Excuse me. And so this is the second comment.
Ms. Stubbs, second comment's the same nature, from a Pam Bronco from 5962 Irish Town Road. Just asking if there's any preliminary plans have been made regarding graduation and commencement ceremony.
Do you want to comment?
The comments that I would make is, I know the high school administration has been working very hard to set a graduation date later in the summer months. My understanding is just today, Governor Wolf has made a proclamation that schools will not be able to hold what he refers to as a traditional graduation ceremony. So I'm going to have to meet with the administration and see what type of alternate plans can be made. And for the two individuals that asked that question, and I know there are many parents and students out there with the same concerns. I actually have a granddaughter who's a a senior in high school, and I know how hard this is on families and children, particularly when they've been looking to have what I'd call a proper and traditional separation from high school. So this is a huge issue. I'll be working with the high school administration, and obviously we've got to do it being compliant with the governor's order. Thank you, Mrs. Davis.
Thank you. Any other comments have come in?
No.
Okay. At this time, then, I ask for a motion to adjourn.
So moved, Connie Rule.
Second, Darren McGregor.
Okay, it's been moved by Ms. Rule and seconded by Mr. McGregor to adjourn the meeting. Can we vote for that?
Yeah, it was giving me trouble there. Okay, now you can vote.
All right, good night, everyone. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
See you next month.